And you come to a point where has it ever been possible where you have packed your bags on time, you've gassed up the vehicle, got your plane ticket, got your train ticket, but it seems like after you've gotten to where you needed to get to, they tell you over the loudspeaker, your flight has been delayed. Seems like in our life we come through places and very intervals of our life where it seems like there is stopping places. And I want you to know that in God there are stopping places, but those stopping places are also making places.
Amen.
And there are times where God has put you to a place where he's trying to not just get you to know yourself, but he wants for you to get to know who he is. May I submit to you that it does not matter what church you belong to, does not matter how long you've been in a particular movement, it does not even matter how long you've been in a particular denomination, but it does matter that you know who Jesus is. We used to sing those songs back in the day, you know, what do you say about Jesus? But we live in a day in this time and in this century where you need to know who God is. Ask your neighbor, say, do you know him? And so we go through delays in our life where it seems like we can't move any further. We go through, as it were, the school days, and we go through elementary school, and we go through junior high school, and we go through high school. It's a wonderful thing to be in kindergarten when you're in the fifth grade, but it's a frustrating thing to be in the kindergarten when you're 18.
Amen.
But let me move on to say to you that there has to be some progression in your life. Somebody say progression. Israel here is in a deplorable state, if you will. They have been in bondage, and I thank and praise God for the witness, Pastor Ken, and let me know that I have the right message, because many times we find ourselves when we are in bondage. We find ourselves, as it were, I heard somebody say, when we are repeating the sins of our fathers. They've done something, and we do the same thing that they've done, and we do the same thing that our grandfathers have done, and what they have done in their lives have been perpetuated from generation to generation to generation. That's why we have, and even in this city, a whole lot of baby daddies and baby mamas. But it takes somebody to teach you how to be a man. Oh my God, my God. And it's hard sometimes, Sister Baker, to be a man when you haven't seen a man. But I came to let you know that you're on your way. You might not have seen anybody do it in your day, but I come to prophesy to you that this is the time. Somebody say, this is the time. And so there has to be some growth. There has to be progression. When that baby is being developed, after a year or so, they start, as it were, walking. But if they don't stay crawling, as it were. And it's a shame that we have people that they are not progressing. I want you to know that anything God calls moves. My God, my God. Somebody say move. You've got to move. There's no sense of you telling God, God mold me and God make me. And you don't want to be squeezed. God will squeeze the breath out of you. But when it seems like you're dead, he'll resuscitate you. And you can say like David, I shall not die, but I shall live. Somebody shout live in here today.
Yeah.
And so there has to be growth. Somebody say, you got to grow. You got to grow. It's a seemingly terrible thing to be stuck in life. You're stuck in relationships. My God, you're loyal to things and people, but the relationship is doing nothing for you. My God, my God. You're stuck in relationships.